Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this painting video, we're going to show you how to paint the neuro disruptor and power weapons of the Corsairs. This is going to be a quick, easy, and achievable way of doing power weapons that also adds a lot of character to your miniatures. The first thing that we're going to need to do is to undercoat the model, and for this we've used grey sear. I've also gone and painted the hilt of the sword and the handle of the gun in order to make it easier for us to see the methods going forward. The first thing that we're going to work on is going to be the neuro disruptor, and for this we're going to be using Space Wolves Grey mixed in with contrast medium. So what I need to do is to get 4 dollops of contrast medium onto my palette. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Wash off the brush, give it a quick dry, and then just get one of Space Wolves Grey, mix that in, and then just twisting the brush to a nice sharp point. And then what I'm going to do is just start putting that all over the neuro disruptor, just letting the paint flow into the recesses. If it starts to pull up anywhere, just dry off your brush and soak it up. You're going to need to do 2 or 3 layers of this mixture in order to build up the color. So with the Space Wolves Grey now dry, we have our nice dark base layer to the neuro disruptor. The next thing that we need to do is to move on to doing the edge highlights. And for this, we'll be using Ulthuan Grey as a thick edge highlight, and then White Scar as a thin edge highlight or spot highlight. So the first thing I'm going to need to do is to get some Ulthuan Grey onto my palette. So there we go. And get some water just to thin it down. Get it to the right consistency. So just make sure just to brush along your palette so you can check the consistency of the paint. And then you can see here, I'm just twisting it just to get it to a nice sharp point. And then what I'm going to do is just run the edge of my brush along all the edges of the crystals, picking them out. Just take your time when doing this and go along picking out all the edges. Trust me, it'll be worth it for the nice effect. So with that stage complete, the next thing to do is to use White Scar as a spot highlight, and you're just looking for all the places where the lines meet. So for instance, this little spot there, and then here, and going around and finding all those places, just giving a little spot. What this will do is just to add more definition to the crystals. Just take your time when doing this. You're looking to gently press down just with the tip of your brush. And with that spot highlight of White Scar complete, our neuro disruptor is finished. The next thing that we need to do is to move on to doing the power weapon. And when doing the power weapon, we're going to be using Athematic Blue mixed in with Contrast Medium. We're then going to use White Scar as an edge highlight. However, when doing the Athematic Blue, we're going to look to build up a crystalline effect in order to make our blade look unique. So in order to do this, the first thing that we need to do is to get some Contrast Medium onto our palette. So what I'm going to do is to get 4 dollops of contrast medium onto the palette. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. And then wash the brush off. Just need to get it dry. And then get some Athematic Blue. And just mix that in. Get our brush dry again so we can control what we're doing. There we go, get the brush to a nice sharp point. Then what we're going to do is just to brush the color along the blade just to set up the initial coat of it. Once it's dry, just do a second layer. Don't forget to do the other side of the blade. So with that first layer done, the next thing that we're going to do is start to build up our dark spots. So what we're going to do here is just to paint Athematic Blue as a layer, just building up a dark area of the blade. And then we have our first one here at the tip. And then I'm going to do another dark spot in the center. So if you notice when I'm painting with it, I'm painting toward where I want the darkest bit to be, which is in the middle. So just rolling the paint into the middle and then over here as well. So the darkest bit will be towards the hilt of the blade. And then on the top section, just need to get a little bit more thematic blue. We're going to look to do a dark section here and then just painting towards the center. Then here as well, and painting towards the center. And once that's dry, just come back and go back over where we've done doing the same technique. So here we go. We're four layers into building up the blue layers of our crystalline blade, and we wanted to show you where you'd be at this stage. What we're going to look to do now is just continue building up the layers and just adding up more of the blue towards the center in order to get that nice dark area. So you see just building up the blue there and then just brushing it towards the center. And you're probably going to need to do quite a few more layers to get that nice deep blue effect. And there we go. With the multiple layers of athematic blue finished, the next thing to do is to move on to using white scar as an edge highlight, just running it along the edges of the blade. What this will do is to help to tie the blade in with the athematic blue to that crystalline effect that we want. With the final edge highlight of white scar on the blade finished, our crystalline effect for the power weapon is complete. Well, there we go. An easy to paint guide of how to do the neuro disruptor and power weapons for the Corsairs. By following this video, you can easily transfer any of the techniques and method you've just seen to any other Corsairs in your collection, as well as to any other armies that you may have. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this painting video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own Corsairs, and we look forward to seeing you again soon. Goodbye.